okay? Someone grab the universal translator. Royal High Priestess Senate something. Oh, and Captain Fear Lattice says Vas Ilursalia Mertamas Vorpasana Sarai. Sure, says the High Priestess. Laconia says, I know of these creatures from the Underdark. Sahuagin, Sharkmen. My home city did not have much contact with them, however, so I do not know their language. Well, not very useful today, are ya? Asuk Philatis, stuff like that. Asuk. Now what? Why are we just standing? Are we? Oh, okay. So are we friends now? Or are we prisoners? So can it understand me now, High Priestess? Says the captain. It must be able to understand. The king awaits. I heard you the first time, Philatis. Yes, I have called on Sekola to grant these beings the ability to understand our tongue. So it understands, High Priestess? Is it dangerous to us? Shall we be forced to collar it? Surface beings are varied in their ways, Philatis, but they are quite intelligent. You can, I am sure, speak to the creatures directly. Yes, we creatures like when you just talk to us. No, no collar, says Minsk. I will not be collared by the smelly fishmen. My warrior spirit will not bear such a thing. Sure, it can't be that much worse than Arrhenicus' dungeon. My apologies. Captain Philatis performs well as protector of our Shark Father's temple, but has little experience with your kind. I am sure this must come as a shock to you after your recent harrowing experience. You must brace yourself, soft ones, for your journey gets no easier. What do you call yourself? Soft one? You calling us soft ones? High Priestess, we must take the surface beings before the king. He commands it. In good time, Philatis. Allow them to gain their bearings and discover why we have brought them here. Otherwise, they may resort to hostilities. I guess we're kind of prisoners? No. No, that must not be allowed, says the captain. What, talk? Letting us gain our composure, or us... excuse me, getting into hostilities. Indeed. Sekola has spoken of these ones to us, so let us treat them not as prisoners for the banquet table. Let us instead make them welcome. Oh, well, we'd appreciate that. I shall introduce myself to you. I am Senate Yili? Royal High Priestess of Sekola. And you are in the City of Caverns, one of our most ancient places. Oh, hope I get to explore the whole thing. Sounds amazing. You are fortunate, surface dwellers. In the normal course of things, creatures captured from the Sunlands would be dinner for our plate. This once, however, is different. Sekola has told of your coming in an ancient prophecy, and I have scried that you are whom the Shark Father speaks of. Oh, we're part of a prophecy? And just think, we could have gone through the portal. That would have brought us to wherever we go after this. Which I have some guesses about, but... The most exalted... Oh boy. King Ixol Thetokal calls for the presence of the prophesied ones now. But there is time for you to ask questions if you have the desire. Alright, well, hopefully get to ask all of them, but just in case. Sahuagin, we know. City of Caverns. Probably in a cave underneath the ocean or something. What is this prophecy you speak of? Ah, yes, the prophecy. Sekola visited the City of Caverns long ago. All raised their arms in rejoicing as the great shark song filled our hearts. Who thought that sharks would have a song? Sekola told of a time when the City of Caverns would be no more. He also told of signs that would precede the arrival of surface dwellers in the depths. Sekola said these surface dwellers would be all that stood between the City of Caverns and destruction, and we would do well to watch for them. We, Sahuagin, as you call us, have watched and waited from our temples here in the city. The signs have come, surface woman, and now you are here. All right, so Sahuagin is not their name for themselves, so that kind of matches their strange, it's a little easier to read than the other words, but... So, who made up Sahuagin? The elves, maybe? You have come, and the City of Caverns does, indeed, stand on the brink of destruction. You will save us, as Sekola has promised. The captain says, Most sacred Senet Yili, the most exalted one, will wait no longer. We must bring the surface beings to him quickly, lest we be punished. Yeah, I had a feeling we don't be able to answer one question. The most honored Ixolthetokol will not punish us, good fear lettuce, but we must hurry, lest Tlisixos convince the king of her views in my absence. Oh. Is that your political rival? So, surface woman, you have heard me tell of the prophecy and your role in it. Will you see the king of Sahuagin to hear more, or will you struggle? I do have more questions. I have more questions to ask of you first. There's no time for more questions, service woman. You will learn more in time, if you are intelligent. The most exalted beckons for your presence. Very well, I'll go with you. Good. Captain Fearlattice, we shall now proceed to the royal chambers. Lead us. At once, most sacred one. I shall also bring the equipment collected from the sunken ship. If they pass the test, they may have any of the things that I found. Oh, yeah. Including all the loot from the fallen people that we didn't get to loot. Do we still have the sword?
We are here, most honorable Ixolthetokol.
Oh.
At your command.
Ixolthetokol? Is that what she said? The prisoner of Sekola.
And these? These are the strange creatures from the surface? These are the ones you claim the mighty Sekola has promised us?
Sorry, it doesn't... I'm reading him laughing and like... Well, I'm hearing him laughing and I'm reading, hee-hee! I guess he finds us humorous. Maybe we can tickle his funny bone. They are, most honorable one. The leader amongst them here is what I believe they refer to as an elf. It seems most strange. They have no scales. Look how small and puny their teeth are. You've never met a human or an elf? Or you've never met any creatures from the above world? That's strange. Because they do fight us from time to time. Boo, too, has small teeth compared to fishmen, but they hurt just the same when they latch onto the eyes. Yes, sir. You must kill it, most exalted one, says Baron Thelocastule. They should not have remained alive. You must kill them, sacrifice them to the Shark Father. The king says, So you keep telling me, Baron... Thelocastule, shall we turn away a gift of Sekola, do you think, then? High Priestess says, The surface creatures are not sent by Sekola, most exalted Ixolthetokol, whatever. They are not the ones spoken of in the Shark Father's prophecy. The High Priestess says, They're not. Is this a different High Priestess? Well, the other High Priestess had a different name. Well, she wasn't a high priestess, she was something else. Okay, so some believe we are sent by the prophecy, and some don't. They are nothing more than spurious beasts that have fallen into our lap. We should sacrifice them and feast upon their meat. Hey, I'm very attached to my meat, thank you. Oh, says the king. Right, okay, so there's the High Priestess and there's the Royal High Priestess. No, most honorable Ixothotokal, the signs were clearly seen. All has come to pass as Sekola had foretold. You know, it reminds me of, like, Mayan names? Maybe? The High Priestess says not all the signs have come. Senetili. Okay, say her name, because I want to know how to say that. Senetili. No, she's the Royal High Priestess. She outranks you. So I'm afraid you must capitulate that we were sent according to the prophecy. I do not see what I wish to say. See, Tlysixus? I see only what Sekola has shown me, and these are the saviors of the City of Caverns. That's right. Tell them. The king says, so... not he. We have an agreement, do we? The High Priestess and consort of my Baron Thelocasiel contest the belief of my own High Priestess, does she? The High Priestess, not the royal one, says, I do, most honorable one. The Baron says she does. It is as we have been trying to tell you, Ixothotokal. These creatures are no more worthy than a meat crab meant for consumption and nothing more. The Royal High Priestess says, no, Ixothotokal, do not listen to them. They are sent by Sekola, I swear. To refuse them is to pledge the City of Caverns to its destruction. The king says, oh, I shall be the judge of that, good Senetili. Oh, yes, I am most surely shall. Tee-hee-hee. Well, doesn't sound like that, I'm sure. What do you think, elf? Yes, you. Do you think you are more worthy than a sea crab? Do you think you are who the prophecy speaks of? I don't think he would believe that. I'm not going to threaten them. I could be. I will help you if I can. Aha! Well, now that sounds promising. I wasn't aware we needed such help, but you never know when a tasty elf might come in handy. Right, and then all of a sudden the city is under attack. Oh, we need your help. Never mind. Please help us. I don't suppose either of the most favored priestesses will change their minds? Relinquish their position in this arbitration, perhaps? Yeah, something's going to force their hand and we're going to fight on their behalf. Most certainly not, says the High Priestess. The Royal High Priestess says no, most honorable Ixothotokal. Ah, I didn't think so, says the king. So be it. We shall decide this with a challenge, we will. Although not a challenge between our dear priestesses. That would solve nothing. Yeah, I know, we're involved. We haven't got a chance to rest yet. That's it. We're pretty okay, though. We wish to see if these surface beasts are truly the ones the Shark Father has spoken of, yes? So I shall offer them the chance to prove their power. Well, elf, will you take this challenge? Will you fight a creature of my choosing, a slave from the surface, and see if you survive? Not me, Senminsk. But... the way that just started sounding as soon as I started to read this one. This is a bad idea to read this. But my colleagues and I are in need of rest and healing. Some of us were wounded during the ship battle. Sekola demands perseverance, strength, and self-reliance, but not stupidity. The priestesses shall heal you before you fight, surface elf. I'm not the one that should be fighting. I mean, are you going to give me back my magic spells, too? I think I used all my minute meteors, maybe? But rest you shall not get. We dislike sorceress powers here, elf. And you shall have no time to study them. Healing should be more than sufficient. I am not a melee combatant. So then, do you agree, my tasty elf? Or do you refuse? What happens if I refuse? Then you are not the ones the prophecy tells of. That would make you intruders, and intruders die. Oh yes, they most certainly do. Very well, shall accept your challenge, then. Excellent, excellent. Sport for us all. Take them away, and let us see what they do against our freakish surface slave. Why is he freakish? Could it be someone I know? Oh, I can't do that. Oh, all of us? Oh, good. I no want fight. I want home. I smash fish. I smash you. Urg. The High Priestess... Oh, yeah, let's read this one first. Taken down into a city far below the ocean surface by the Sahuagin, I was greeted by High Priestess Senetili of the dark god Sekala and told that I was intended for some higher purpose that Sekala had foretold in a prophecy. I do not know what is in store for me, but I am now being taken to the Sahuagin king. The High Priestess seems to think that I am the one her prophecy has spoken of, and that I will save this Sahuagin city. Another priestess disagreed, who's also called High Priestess, and King Ixilthetokal decided that a trial by combat was needed to settle the issue. I have accepted the challenge. Okay, so I thought this was going to be like when we fought in the, is it the Ruin Grove? The Druid Grove? And we sent one person, and there was something else too. With one person fighting. And, yeah, back at the, some kind of temple? A monk temple? Who are we helping? We were helping, it was Rasad's quest. There was some kind of battle as well. And I just kind of, I think I ran around and threw, minute meteors. I had to stay, out of melee range, obviously. But now it seems to be all of us. So, there's also a... We're all healed. But then a Githyanki attacking a pirate and a Sahuagin. And pirate attacking Githyanki. I don't know why this is... like, thrown in the middle. Oh, I just want to see something. They took it, didn't they? Though I still have it. I have the silver blade. Oh, it's not even, like, magical? I guess successfully identified it. With lore. Alright. Could it be lore? Alright, so that is an Ettin. I'd prefer to help him escape to the surface. I mean, I don't want to fight him any more than he wants to fight us.
Ready and willing.
Alright, so let me just see something. Yeah, we didn't... Oh, we're still hasted. We're still hasted. That's awesome. Alright. And Ettin is evil.
Boo says, what?
Don't attack yet, that's what. See if we can get off protection from evil. Where is she? Vaconia, okay. Oh, look. I see our way out over there.
Right you are.
Oh, she agrees.
You point! I...
What can I do?
About bless.
What? Fine.
Ustan Zadost.
Bolt of Glory.
Alright, alright.
She's hidden.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Yeah, it didn't work like that, right? Let's see. Right, because I switched to the blade, brought her out. Well, as long as they didn't turn around and hit her, she can just keep hitting them from behind like that. Okay.
Next time.
Well, Blast just went off. Oh, I paused it. I couldn't hear that. The king says, "Congratulations, my wondrous little elf. You're indeed a mighty specimen, and the one sent to us by Sekola, I might add." Ah, so now he agrees. The baron says, "No, most exalted Exlatokal, you cannot be serious." "Oh, stop complaining, baron. And you messed up saying my name again. So your high priestess lost the challenge. That's too bad. There's no need to go on whining about it. Time to take her away for sacrifice? Try not to get caught in Sekola's teeth, Fly Sixus. I'm sure he wouldn't appreciate it." Okay, so it's the old, you know, it's the Game of Thrones type of thing. Trial by combat. If we win, you know, whoever wins has been helped by the gods and they're supposed to win. No, maybe just five of us gang up on one poor Ettin. Maybe that's it. High Priestess says, I see. Of course, most exalted Exaltatokal. What a drama we have playing out here. So if I had gone through the portal, I would miss all this.
Now that little dispute is over with, perhaps we can get down to real business, eh?
Oh, say the name. Are you bitter, Thilocasule? The baron says, no, most exalted one. As long as the prophesied ones deal with the rebels, they will have served the purpose Sekola intended. Oh, so there's rebels? I didn't know that. The rebels. That's right, says the king. And here I was on my coral throne, forgetting all about those rebels. This is an excellent task to set those surface dwellers on. The Royal High Priestess says, if I may speak, most honorable one, as to the Shark Father's intentions? Are you still here, Senatili? Didn't I just have you sacrificed? No, that was the other High Priestess. That was Tlysixus, Honorable Ixtlatokal. Oh, how disappointing. Well, I suppose you can speak then. He doesn't have such a good memory, does he? I urge you not to listen to the Baron. He would have you destroy the rebels when there was a far greater need for them in the City of Caverns. Our numbers dwindle, Honorable Ixtlatokal. You have exiled many. The hatcheries are barren, and there are too few females. In short, our bloodline grows thin. We need these rebels to join us, to add their blood to ours, so that the City of Caverns may grow strong again. The king says, I see what you say, Senatili. Oh yes, I do. We should have the rebel and his army join us. In principle, the drow and the illithids take more each year. I have no wish to retreat to the depths. Okay. So they've seen drow before. They don't have scales. Well, then again, he's a pretty stupid king, isn't he? He just sent his high priestess away to be exiled and then forget about it, like three sentences later. So yeah, the fact that he doesn't recognize us doesn't mean much to me now. But no, I'd rather have the rebel's heart. There's one rebel or a bunch of rebels? But Honorable Ixtatokel. Excellent decision, our king, says the Baron. I thought you would like that, my Baron. But I am not doing it for you. The rebel will invade with his army of exiles if he isn't stopped, you know. So it comes down to you, Surface Elf. I am sure you have no wish to help such a race, to help a race such as us. But if you have no objection to killing a few, hunt down the rebel leader for me, my elf. Bring me his heart, and I shall reward you with great riches. We'd best be careful, Sapphire, says Imwin. I don't know how much I trust this king to remember we're supposed to be rewarded and not eaten, you know. Your kind does not object to sorcery, says the king. We have collected much that is magical during our raids. You are welcome to it all if you bring me his heart. Wow. So, what do you say to that, my surface elf, chosen of Sekhola? Who is the rebel? Before negotiate peace. Who is this rebel, and where would I find him? Oh, this particular one is a former rival for my position that I sent away years ago. What was his name again, my Baron? The Baron says, Prince Villainati, Exalted One. Right, Villainati. You can find the rebels outside the city. He should be no match for one as powerful as you, my little elf. Carve my way out of here with my blade. Well, I don't have a blade. I have a dagger, I think. I would prefer to negotiate a peace, as the High Priestess suggests. Well, I don't want a peace. I want his heart. You're the chosen of Sekhola, after all, and the rewards are being magnificent, I can assure you. I can't fight this rebel if I'm a prisoner. Prisoner? You are the chosen of Sekhola, my little surface elf. You have been sent to us by the prophecy. After we're done here, you can wander off on your way. Rest, rearm yourselves, whatever it is that you surface people enjoy doing. Okay. Automatically alt-tab the desktop again. An hour later, so it seems to be once an hour, we'll get dropped the desktop twice. Oh, yeah. Anyway, whatever it is that you surface people enjoy doing, I suppose. Soon you'll leave the city and kill this rebel prince, saving the City of Caverns as the prophecy foretells, and I shall reward you with great riches. Until that time, you'll have the free run of the City of Caverns. Go where you wish, my good elf. The Baron says, but most honored one, you wish to let them loose in the city? They're doing us a great service, my Baron. I want everyone to treat them like oddly colored, small-toothed, skinny fellow Sahuagin. Yes, like that. Okay. Well, I already said these two. Very well, I will try to find this rebel you speak of and return his heart to you. Good. The less rebels running about, the better. You shall save the city and be rewarded. Everyone will be happy, except for Villainati. And the Baron. And the High Priestess. We'll be dead soon. And then you'll be free to go off to the Underdark, if that's where you're headed. That's right. Did he flee there, Ernicus? Something like that. Unless you'd care to try the oceans again, my little elf. But off you go, chosen ones. I desire meat now, and the king always dines in private. The Royal High Priestess says, before you leave the city, surface beings, come to the temple and speak to me again. I can tell you things that will make your job much easier. Well, we enjoy things being easier. The king says, yes, our priestess shall tell you how to gain access to the rebel camp. The rebels are locked away with magic, you know. Go now and destroy them. Hee-hee. Oh, is that why there are rebels? Because they're using magic, I guess. Alright, I have defeated the king's monster, and he has ordered the opposing priestess sacrifice to Sekola. I am now the chosen one, and the king intends to have me kill the leader of a group of rebels outside of the city, and to return with his heart, for which he will reward me with great riches. I am to see High Priestess Senetili in her temple to get more information on how to reach the rebel encampment. Until then, I have run of the city. Alright. So we're going to avoid talking to her, because she might send us into, you know, like, you must go now, kind of thing. So I guess they forgot all about this sword. Because we still... We still have it. I hid it away in the bag of holding. Possibly that's why we still have it, but... Alright, we can't talk to the High Priestess. We can talk to all these people, or beings. Royal Guard. You are the surface creatures. I have fought many of your kind on raids to the surface shores. The most exalted one has commanded your safety. For now. Oh! I didn't realize we had stuff. We have stuff. Magical bolts. Bolt of biting. That's right, she has the ammo. Paralytic bolt. Okay. Here's the Baron.
No problem at all.
Stand away from me, surface creature. Your scaleless features fill me with more than a little revulsion. Do as the most honored Ixtlilatokl has commanded you, and I shall be content. We care not for your contentedness. Oh, our spell's wearing off. Many of our... Ooh, now I hear water. Ocean, like waves. Many of your kind have died well on the end of my blade, and their meat has tasted all the better for the victory. I shall not kill you, however, until the most exalted one commands it. Well, I appreciate that. You are the surface creatures. I have fought many of your kind on raids to the surface shores. The most exalted one has commanded your safety for now. I thought that sounded familiar. That's what the other one said. And here's the king. It definitely is bigger than the others.
You are wondrously strange.
No, I do not wish to speak to you, whatever you are. Send my favorite little surface elf to speak to me. I find that one more amusing. What if she is? Well, she's a human. Looks very similar to me, only different ears. Let's heal,
I am yours to command.
Oh my. Well, let's heal Minsk. Oh, magic. I imagine somehow they're good with divine magic. Like the ones in the city. They don't care if you send off priest spells. But the second you let loose an arcane spell, they freak. Alright, he wants... Only I can talk to him.
Such menial tasks.
Talking to a king, a menial task. Aha, my favorite surface elf wishes to speak to me once again. Do you have the heart of that rebel? I would so enjoy eating it now. No, we have not moved from our spot. But I intend to get it. Well, what are you waiting for? The rebel awaits. I would like to be there when he sees your hairy hides, but a king can't have everything. Okay. Royal throne room. Okay. This is going to be a lot of fun exploring this place. Which we go first? To the door?
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Oh, there's the where we fought. We can't exit here. Alright, let's go in here.
Swords, not words. The bigger they are, the harder I hit.
That's locked.
Something up? You can count on me.
Huh. This magical lock will only open for a specific key. No amount of tinkering will help. Oh, that.
Minsk and Boo stand ready.
That takes care of that for a while.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
So I assume we're safe here. We just travel freely. That's what they were saying. If they are to be believed. Oh, there's Captain Fear Lattice. The most sacred Sinatili would wish to speak with you as soon as you can, surface creature. I ask that you seek her out.
An offering for you, Sokola. Open your mighty jaws and take this, your former servant, as sustenance for you.
Huh? We are mighty, Shark Father, she continues. We strike without fear and without remorse. Take this gift as a measure of our power. Oh, they're sacrificing the other High Priestess. She's yelling, no! Jade Ring. Ah, it is good you have come to see me before you left. The king has made it clear I should instruct you as to how you may enter the prince's base. Well, we're not doing that yet. We're looking around. The prince's base lies at the far end of the city, beyond a chamber with two great doors. Long ago, Sekala appeared there and slew 1,000 infidels. Wow. That's a lot of infidels.